Hi there, this is our latest model, a 330 DC CNC automatic bandsaw. We've been supplying machines from this manufacturer now for some 16 years. We've sold hundreds of their machines. I've prepared a small video for you so you can see all the salient points of this model. The machine has a very heavy cast iron bow. This is essential for vibration-free cutting. It has a 34mm blade, which is much better than the 27 on a lot of machines. It has adaptive downfeed on these two valves, more about that later, and carbide tips to guide the blade, and huge amount of coolant supply here, which is going to give you very good results on the cutting and also flush all the swarf away. These two adaptive valves allow the machine to be very sensitive in operation. When you're cutting round bars, for instance, when you go through the thin part of the round bar at the top, the machine will be cutting faster. The valves will then sense the load going through the middle of the bar where it's heavier and slow down. And then gradually as it gets towards the bottom of the bar and it gets narrower again, the machine will speed up. This will give you straighter cuts, faster cuts, and much longer blade life. As you can see, there's an LED work light here and a flushing hose to remove all the swarf at the end of a cycle of cuts. The machine has a 3kW motor and goes up and down on the linear guides. These are standard on CNC machine tools today. Opening up the guard now. You have the feed vise with its supporting rollers going up and down on two huge pillars here, fed by a ball screw. As you can see, the ball screw is covered up so no swarf gets on it. It's a very accurate mechanism. See the back of the machine with the two vices and the blade in the front. This is the roller track for the work and a support roller. Obviously, you can buy additional roller tracks with or without support rollers. As you can see, this is a swarf auger driven by a motor and gearbox, removing the swarf from the cut all the way out of the machine and exiting outside the machine into a bin that you can put underneath. All European controls in here, as you can see, they're nicely grouped together and labelled up for easy maintenance. Inside here we have the coolant tank. As you can see, it's made of stainless steel so it won't rust away like you see some tanks, and it can be slid out for cleaning and maintenance. Over here we have the hydraulic pack. There is a valve here for adjusting the clamping pressure. If you were cutting thin wall pipes, you can reduce the pressure. And again, the hydraulic pack, two screws, and you can slide it out for maintenance. You can see the filter there. Okay, the control panel. Obviously, important thing, emergency stop button here. This is the downfeed rate of the machine, the speed the machine comes down initially, but obviously the sensitive valves take over from that point. This is the blade speed, the velocity of the blade for cutting all your materials, anything from stainless steel right up to mild steel, aluminium, etc. Over here we have the control. You can have the machine in manual mode, so you can operate everything independently, setting the machine up. You can have it in semi-automatic mode, which means that the machine will just go down, do a cut, and go back up again. Or you can have it in fully automatic mode, NC mode, and that way it's in permanent cutting automatic. Down here, you program the machine, and I'll show you that with a closer shot. You can store up to 45 different jobs, regular jobs that you do. And it's very easy to reprogram the machine to do other jobs at a moment's notice. On the right hand side here, it's showing what the vise does. You can have the vise so it goes right back, clamps the work, and then comes forward again. You might use that on long pieces. On short pieces, you can have it incremental because the vise is controlled with a ball screw. It can move forward a little bit at a time. So if you're cutting billets off, say 10 millimeters long, you can use this program that just makes it come forward a little bit at a time. And then when it's finished, it'll go back and then come forward again until you finish the number of pieces you want to do. But this one is for the longer jobs. So you can choose which one you use. You program the number of pieces you want to cut here. You can see I've got three pieces there. The height of the workpiece, I mean, obviously you allow a couple of millimeters to material to go through. That's 38 millimeters at the moment. And the length of the components at 10 millimeters. It's as simple as that. Right, we're going in to do some automatic cuts. It's a very small piece of metal on there. I haven't got any coolant on the machine, it's brand new. By the way, you can have our optional vegetable spray unit, which puts tiny amounts of vegetable spray, very environmentally friendly, on the blade, and therefore you won't end up with any coolant on the floor. So you can ask for that option.